Well, good afternoon. It is almost 3 o'clock. I am back down the farm. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do, but talking with my brother, we both felt the same way. We gotta go back here and try and hunt this buck. So I'm by myself again tonight. David's taking his daughter to a little bit of a festival, outdoor fall festival. But he is on standby if I get lucky. So I'm gonna take a slow walk back. It's rather warm right now. And gonna try not to get sweated too much. And hopefully the bugs don't kill me while I'm walking back. And I just want to take a nice, easy stroll. Try not to bounce anything if it's bedded. There's another stand I'm going to go to where my wife and I doubled up on some doe in rifle season last year. And it's closer to the hardwoods bedding. So I want to get back there nice and early, get set up, and then boy, the bugs are bad right now. And sit for the evening, so I'll see you guys up in the stand. Stopping to take a little break. I'm about 300 yards or so from where I want to go. But I got bedding all around me, so I'm just gonna take my time and hopefully slip up in there without bouncing anything that's bedded. It's a little warm, the bugs are bad right now, so. And I'll show you, this is where this big field on the other side of these trees over here is where that buck was. I don't know if it came from here or if it was laying in there, but he ran this way. Okay, the last time I saw him was going into these trees like up in here, and I'm going up into this corner up here tonight. So I'm looking for either a nice doe, or I'd like to see that buck and have a crack at him tonight, so. At least we got a little bit of a breeze that's keeping it cool. I'm not sweating too bad. But, I just want to take my time. We got lots of time until last light, so. But there's so many areas for him to be right now, which is great. And it also helps me for sneaking in, so. Guys, I'll see you up in a tree. I made it back nice and quiet. We didn't bounce any deer out of any beds. So, I'm pretty happy about that. It's a little warm. I'm sweating a little bit. Once I got here, I had some work to do. I had a shooting rail up from rifle season yet. And I just needed to disconnect that and slide it behind the backrest of the seat. And take care of a few other things, so. Real cloudy and overcast. There's probably have some passing showers, you know, here and there, but nothing major. Got a really nice rub I saw down here as I was coming in. That's worked really. That's fresh. So I'm kind of hoping that buck is still in the area that I saw this morning, and he works his way out here. We can get a shot at him tonight. I'm gonna try to not have to stand up. The less movement, the better. I was watching the footage, and I think that deer caught me this morning as I was making one final adjustment on the camera because he was getting close and starting to get out of frame on me. But either way, I still didn't have a good shot because he was facing straight on, so he just didn't know what I was. Never blew, he just turned and went, so.
That's a good thing.
It's 5 o'clock. Nothing yet, but I didn't really expect anything this early. I just wanted to get back here and slip in nice and quiet and let everything settle down. There's always that chance, but it was about 60 degrees when I got down here, so cooled off a little bit. And I anticipate probably not seeing anything until that last hour again, 6 o'clock on. So I'm just going to sit back and enjoy the evening. Got a comfortable seat. And hopefully it's the front row when everything starts to happen. So we got about 30 minutes to sunset. There's a deer right there. There's that big buck right there. There he is. He's coming out. Coming out to the field. In that ditch. Number two deer. I knew he didn't go far when I saw him this morning. He's probably bedded up in there. He's in that long ditch right there that runs all the way down. There was another, I don't know if it was a doe or a young buck with him that was following. Heard me grunt, and then he kept going, and it looked like he was coming back here.
see if I can get on him. Just standing right there. Small buck. Maybe that'll draw him out. Thank you. shot right over him. Dang it.
The end of that hunt. I just screwed that up royally. There he goes. He's just walking off. I shot right over his back on the first shot. I think I used the wrong pin. He was 30 yards. I think I used my 40-yard pin. He was coming so quick, he wouldn't stop in the window I wanted. He stopped right there. I shot right over his back. Then I had, and I wasn't. Or two doe came right underneath me. My camera arm kept sliding around. I couldn't get on him. The one was right here at 10 yards, I could have shot it. And then when I looked back out in the field, the two small bucks and the big buck were coming across, and they were working their way up. And he was there at 30 yards. And I used my 40-yard pin, I shot right over his back. Just trying to rush everything by yourself, self-filming. And then the second time he was coming back in, he was at 40 yards. And I hit the trigger. I hit the barrel on my thumb before I was ready, and it hit off of this tree in front of me and completely shattered the arrow. What a day. I can see my arrow that I missed him with the first shot down there. The nock's lit up. He's all the way down there, getting ready to go into the woods. So I'm gonna pack up. I'm gonna walk out of here and shake it off. There's plenty of hunting to go, but I'm pretty disgusted right now. I just screwed this up so bad, it's not even funny. I'm just having a heck of a time tonight trying to film. I don't know, nothing was working right for me. The good part is the deer is not wounded. I'll let it settle down and get back after him, but I messed up. Thanks for watching. Thanks for following me. This is hunting. There's nothing staged about this. This is real. Real emotions, real. Real everything. Jeez. All right. See you guys.